in The Adventures of Shaun the Sheep. But how do Aardman bring Shaun and his friends to life?
So here they're actually, you can actually see them, they're visible. Yeah.
First, they write a story and draw everything that happens in each episode. These pictures, which illustrate the story, are called a storyboard. With all this practice, the artists get very good at drawing Shaun. The storyboard pictures are then put into a computer, where they become a rough version of the program called an animatic. Next, they make models of all your favourite characters. There's Shaun, the naughty pigs, the farmer, and the bull.
In one of the episodes, we get a huge ball of sheep which go rolling across the countryside, and as he rolls them along, it's all controlled by the rig.
Because each model needs to be constantly adjusted, the animators give them special metal skeletons, like the farmer's legs here. They're called armatures. They bend easily into whatever shape is needed. So, now you know how your favourite characters are made, one tiny piece at a time. But what about creating the rest of the farmyard? The Aardman team makes sure that everything in Shaun the Sheep is as lifelike as possible. To help them get everything just right, they look at actual photographs of farms. From the farmyard buildings to the vegetable patch, every tiny little detail must look real.
It is solid.
Even the windscreen wipers on the farmer's Land Rover. Once everything's in place, Shaun the Sheep is ready for action. Now it's time to animate Shaun and his friends using stop-motion animation. Here's how it works.
It's serious. Enjoy the good life, man. He's licking his lollies, watching TV.
The camera takes a photograph. Then the animator moves the model slightly and takes another photo. And then they do it again. And again. And again. This goes on for a long time, because it takes 12 photographs to create just 1 second of the program. Let's take a look at what happens when they put all these photographs together. Bitzer finally gets to lick his lolly. So, from the first drawings to the final animation, you now know the secret behind bringing the farmyard gang to life.
We're going to make a point at one end, and the other end is rounded, it's like a leaf shape. So we need two of them. And then you can make a little cut in the top of the head, where the ears would be. And just pull out the bottom of the ear there. And stick that little tab into the indentation.
Yeah,
that's brilliant. Pull out the bottom of the other one. Stick it in there. There, it's got two little ears.
Look, he's listening.
And then we need to make his arms and legs. So they're basically just sausages. So I've rolled out one long sausage, and then I'm going to cut it into sections. I'm going to do the arms first. So you just round off one end, flatten the other end. You could use a flat-ended tool, and where you've squished the end, just make a little cut, and that would be his trotter. So if I just make a dip like that, And then you get your arm, and then you can just stick it into there. And hopefully they'll stay in a bit better. It's got quite short little arms. And we need some legs. The legs again are just two little sausages with a trotter cut into it. And you can be sitting down. You just stick his legs underneath his tummy. Brilliant! He's lovely.
My little piggy.
And what's the last thing that a pig has?
Tail.
A tail. Yep. And that is just a thin sausage of plasticine. I'm just going to curl it around this tool. And for the tail, if you make a little hole in, at the bottom in his back, yeah, you can stick the base of the tail in there. Hopefully, there we are, that just slots in there. There we have him. There he is. Brilliant, you've got a catapult and everything. Do you want to do a pig display?
No, he's pretty good. Oh. His arm is broken.
I'm just into seeing how I can make him hold a catapult.
Mine looks a bit like a duck.
That's lovely. That's brilliant.